Praise God! The 10th Episcopacy of Right Reverend Ephrem Okechukwu-Ikako and 10th Anniversary of the Anglican Diocese of Amichi comes up on Monday 7th through Sunday 13th January 2019. It's a power-packed week-long event which kicks off with a world press conference to be addressed by the Bishop at the Cathedral Church of St. Andrew's Amichi on Monday, 7th January 2019 at 9 a.m. On Friday, 11th January 2019, comes a corporate Eucharistic service in commemoration of the Bishop's consecration at the Cathedral at 10 a.m. On Saturday, 12th January 2019, dedication of the ultra-modern Diocesan Secretariat, Women Bethany House, the Shen Shopping Complex, College of Nursing Sciences Admin Block and Hostels at 10 a.m. On Sunday, 13th January 2019, it will be wrapped up with Thanksgiving service and fundraising in support of Diocesan projects at the Cathedral at 10 a.m. God's people, be part of this great occasion. Jesus Christ is Lord forever.
Touch with God is an outreach program of the Church of Nigeria Anglican Communion Diocese of Amichi. As you keep and maintain a very close walk with God in your daily living, and as you continue to watch this program, In Touch with God, the Almighty and ever-faithful God will take care of every aspect of your life and needs, including eternal life in His kingdom. Why not join us as Right Reverend Ephrem Ikako presents the realities of the Word of God that can change your life. Your life will never remain the same.
Out of the world economic crisis, the Lord will create opportunity for promotion in the name of Jesus Christ.
Thank you. for them. Ancient and modern, 65, old little town of Bethlehem.
Thank you. and God of mercy. We thank you because of your mercy and love, which made you to give your Son Jesus to be born as man, to redeem us from our sins and give us a hope of eternal life. May it please you, Lord, in this homily, that you will give us your Christmas encouragement through your word, that our lives will not only celebrate Christmas emotionally, but spiritually, we depict the meaning of Christmas, where all we see and give you glory. And may we share in the blessings of Christmas all the days of our lives. In Jesus Christ's name we have prayed.
Amen.
Praise ye the Lord.
The Lord's name be praised.
I say again, praise ye the Lord.
The Lord's name be praised.
Welcome you heartily and happily to 2018 Christmas Carol with this great school, the Master's Versus Seminary in the Bishop's Court. It has been a wonderful evening, very memorable, very joyful and joyous to sing, to dance, to be joyful. You have your Bible. Can we look at one verse, just one verse of the Bible? The book of Prophet Isaiah, chapter 7, verse 14 only. Isaiah chapter 7 and verse 14. Therefore, the Lord himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and you shall call his name what?
Emmanuel.
That's the prophecy that God gave to mankind, beginning from the nation of Israel, about the birth of Jesus Christ. This prophecy took some 100 years or more before its fulfillment. But just as the Bible said in Psalm 119 verse 89, it said, "Forever, O Lord, your word is settled in heaven." And one of the occasions Jesus himself was talking, he said, "Heaven and earth can pass away, but one jot of the word of God can never pass away." So God gave this prophecy through the prophet Isaiah. I said, look, when the Israelites were doing a lot of things, if you read from chapter 6, leaving God to worship other gods, infuriating God, and became worshippers of Baal and other idols, God became angry. And in the midst of these things they were doing, they were also requesting for sign to know whether God is in their midst and why God is not showing them sign. If you read that chapter from verse 1, he said, "You ask me for a sign, yet you weary me even in the midst of asking for these signs. But let me give you this prophecy," he told them. "The Lord himself shall give you a sign." That's where we read. "Behold, a virgin shall conceive." That's a mystery that scientists cannot tell how it happened. Because scientifically, biologically, a man and a woman must meet sexually before conception can take place in the womb of a woman. So it looks laughable. It looked laughable when the prophet Isaiah said, "Look at the sign God will give you." a virgin. Of course, you know the meaning of a virgin. A girl that has never met a man sexually. But this Bible, the prophecy said, this girl that has never had any sexual relationship with a man shall conceive. That's a serious matter. That when you want to look at God, like some of us, this message will always give you hope. That thing Jesus said, I think in Mark chapter 9 from verse 23 to 24, he summarized by saying, with men, some of these things are impossible, but with God, all things are possible. How can a girl conceive without meeting a man? He said, hey, I give you a sign. So Christmas is a time we really have to believe the word of God, no matter how difficult the situation is. Allow the word of God to rule over that situation and you will see miracle in Christmas. Say, I will give you this sign. It looks impossible. Scientifically, it looks stupid. By human logic, it looked laughable. But whether you like it or not, what God has said, he has said, and it will surely come to pass. Said, this virgin shall conceive. And he even went ahead to give a name to this child that will be born mysteriously, yet miraculously. He said, the name of this child shall be called what? Emmanuel. What is the meaning of Emmanuel?
God with us.
God with us. Before Jesus comes, or before he came through this birth we celebrate at Christmas, men sinned against God and God withdrew from the affairs of men. So God was no more with men, with women, with the world, and Satan took over. Man became helpless. Man became hapless. Man became powerless. Sicknesses, diseases, satanic oppression, satanic suppression, satanic torment, everywhere. Satan was having a field day until the presence of God through the birth of Jesus came back to man, and that is Emmanuel. The highest thing you can have in your life, listen very well, because I told you it's a homily, it's not a sermon. The highest thing you can pray and acquire in your life, if I put it to you as question now, many of us will tell you, acquire American visa, acquire private jet, acquire dollars in millions, acquire this or that, but take it everywhere. If you don't get any message I give you at Christmas, Christmas is when the presence of God came to dwell with man.
Hallelujah. Praise God. The 10th Episcopacy of Right Reverend Ephraim Okechukwu Ikako and 10th Anniversary of the Anglican Diocese of Amichi comes up on Monday 7th through Sunday 13th January 2019. It's a power-packed week-long event which kicks off with a world press conference to be addressed by the Bishop at the Cathedral Church of St. Andrew's Amichi on Monday, 7th January 2019 at 9 a.m. On Friday, 11th January 2019, comes up corporate Eucharistic service in commemoration of the Bishop's consecration at the Cathedral at 10 a.m. On Saturday, 12th January 2019, dedication of the ultra-modern Diocesan Secretariat, Women Bethany House, the Shen Shopping Complex, College of Nursing Sciences Admin Block and Hostels at 10 a.m. On Sunday, 13th January 2019, it will be wrapped up with Thanksgiving service and fundraising in support of the Diocesan projects at the Cathedral at 10 a.m. God's people, be part of this great occasion. Jesus Christ is Lord forever.
Therefore, the highest thing you can acquire in your life to succeed, to survive, to excel, and to prosper is the presence of God. Once God is with you, you are immune from sin, because the presence of God drives away sin. Once God is with you, you are protected from satanic oppression. Once God is with you, the presence of God is with you, no man can destroy you. Let all the witches in your village come against you. The presence of God gives us victory. And this is the joy of Christmas. That is why, if you go home, you begin to read Exodus chapter 33. Just read it from verse 1. The same thing that drives away the presence of God, the Israelites indulged in it. They began to commit sin. They began to become idolatrous. They began to emulate other nations, the Moabites, the Canaanites, the Hivites, the Jebusites, worshipping the same. God said to Moses, come. If you read that book of Exodus from chapter 3, where God commissioned Moses to go and save Israel, he will always tell Moses, he will call the Israelites my people. When he wants to talk to Moses about the Israelites, he said, I have seen the affliction of my people. I have seen their tears. I have seen their sorrows. Therefore, Moses, I am sending you to deliver my people from the hand of Pharaoh, from the land of Egypt, from the land of destruction, to a land flowing with milk and honey. He will always call them whenever. When he sent Moses, he said, what will I tell Pharaoh when I get there? He said, thus says the Lord. The message you give to Pharaoh. What was the message? Pharaoh, let my people do what?
Go.
But go, read from chapter 1 to 32. Then come to chapter 33. God changed his language. Listen to me. Check this Christmas, whatever that will make God to reject you and subject you to another government and rulership, avoid it. In that chapter, God said, look, Moses, I will no longer go with you. Take these people. He was talking to Moses. He said, carry these people, your own people, whom you brought from Egypt. Continue this journey. My presence will no longer go with you. He changed from calling the Israelites his people and calling them Moses' people. That is what rebellion, disobedience, and sin can make. Severing you from the presence of God. And once the presence of God withdraws from you, Satan will celebrate over the person's life, because nothing will restrict him. He said, Moses, go, 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 go. Do you know why I love Moses? He's always a spiritually alert human being, unlike some of us. I read that place carefully. I said, if I were Moses, I would say, no problem. If east doesn't go, west will go. Because the next thing God promised, he said, Moses, don't worry. I will send my angels before you. He will go with you. He will fight for you. He will lead you. But for me, my presence will no longer go with you, because I will consume you. But there's something he told Moses. He said, Moses, as this angel is going with you, be careful with him. He's not like me, oh. When my presence is there, mercy and grace are available. But this man I'm sending, the angel, he has no mercy in his dictionary. He said, once you misbehave, he will crush all of you in the wilderness. And that's what people are suffering today. Listen to me, when the presence of God is with you, most of the punishments we deserve is withdrawn from us. Mercy speaks more than law. And that is what Christmas, God brought his presence in the person of Jesus. Moses prayed a prayer. He said, God,
Thank you because your angel will be going with us. Thank you for that. Thank you. But, oh God, if your presence will not go with us, we are not stepping out of this place. He knew the implication. Many people are traveling the whole world, pursuing academics, pursuing business, pursuing ministry, pursuing career, without the presence of God. How do you secure His presence? There is no magic. There is no other magic. You can only secure God's presence by loyalty and obedience to His voice and His word. That's all. Only the unalloyed obedience. Others are doing everything. The question is, does the word of God support me to do it? Does the voice of God encourage me to do it? Any man that lives in the presence of God is a victor perpetually. This prosperity people are struggling to get, there is nothing that assures prosperity like the presence of God. Emmanuel, God with you. I don't know how many of us here who are celebrating Christmas without the presence of God. Sin, ungodliness, and unrighteousness, they are extinguishers of the presence of God. Have you heard about fire extinguisher? Fire extinguisher. What does he do? If you use it on any fire, what does he do? It quenches it. That is exactly what sin, ungodliness, unrighteousness, what they do as far as presence of once mehe batara, God they withdraw. And God withdraw, there is no vacuum in life, spiritually and physically. Once the presence of God goes away, the presence of the devil and his angels and cohorts will take over. That's why itinya keba as I'm in the village on itinya keba as metere. Yes, but the presence of God crushes whatever our forefathers committed. People of God, the presence of God makes everything you need in life available to you. Christmas, Emmanuel. The presence, once you have Him, you have not offended Him, you have not infuriated Him, you have not quenched Him, you have not extinguished Him. The presence of, you say, how can God not give you all this? What do you need? Stop running from pillar to post, stop doing all this. Seek the presence of God, pursue it. Refuse to compromise. Refuse to do things like every other young man, every other woman, anywhere. Do only things that please God. Say, how can God not give you? Do you need money? He will give you all things. Do you need intelligence, your academics, wisdom? Seek God through Christmas, Emmanuel. He gives you academic excellence. Do you need protection? All things. Do you need your business, the business of your parents to prosper? God gives all things. Only if you are walking with His presence. Christmas is made up of two words. Do you know? Christ and what?
Mass.
Mass. What is Christ? Do you know the meaning of Christ?
Jesus.
No, the anointed Messiah. The anointed king. The anointed ruler. The redeemer of the world. What is mass? Celebration or thanksgiving. The way you hear the Roman Catholic say they are going for mass, they know what they are talking about. Every morning I sing in Ijego morning. Ijego no toto I celebrated Jesus. Oh, yeah, nah, joking. Ijego no toto I celebrated the goodness of God, the presence of God. So Christmas is a celebration and thanksgiving because of who? Christ. So anything you do at Christmas that does not bring glory and joy and celebration on behalf of Christ is what they call a misnomer and aberration.
mmadụ iweta egbe ọ chọrọ ije nta maọbụ ije gbanụ maọbụ ije chenche bulite egbe na-apụ were paketị egbe mapụ oge eche ọ na-eje agha rapụ egbe n'ụlọ isi ọdị onye ahụ mma. So onye ọbụla na-akwa efe Christmas without the presence of Jesus running away from sin of all categories ọkwa egbe ka ịrapụ n'ụlọ bụrụ paketị egbe ndị iro biteghị aka agbaghị jaja. I give to you the message of Christmas. Don't ever miss Emmanuel during Christmas. Stand up and let us pray.
Praise God. The 10th Episcopacy of Right Reverend Ephraim Okechukwu Ikako and 10th Anniversary of the Anglican Diocese of Amichi comes up on Monday 7th through Sunday 13th January 2019. It's a power-packed week-long event which kicks off with a world press conference to be addressed by the Bishop at the Cathedral Church of St. Andrew's Amichi on Monday 7th January 2019 at 9 a.m. On Friday 11th January 2019 comes up Corporate Eucharistic Service in commemoration of the Bishop's consecration at the Cathedral at 10 a.m. On Saturday 12th January 2019, dedication of the ultra-modern Diocesan Secretariat, Women Bethany House, the Shen Shopping Complex, College of Nursing Sciences Admin Block and Hostels at 10 a.m. On Sunday 13th January 2019, it will be wrapped up with Thanksgiving service and fundraising in support of Diocesan projects at the Cathedral at 10 a.m. God's people, be part of this great occasion. Jesus Christ is Lord forever.
Are you really walking with the presence of God in your life? Is there anything in your life that is driving His presence away so that Emmanuel at Christmas will not be with you? Say, a virgin shall bring, conceive and bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Emmanuel, God with us. Can you lay your right hand on your chest? We pray together. Father, I thank you for today, giving us opportunity to celebrate your presence. Christmas is a wonderful time to remember Emmanuel in our lives, in our career, in our ministries, in our families. But the enemy is struggling so hard to take away the presence of God from us by pushing us to do things that will make you to withdraw. Lord, during this Christmas, we ask for one thing. May we always have grace never to lose your presence in the name of Jesus Christ. Anywhere we find ourselves during Christmas, after Christmas, Lord, may we work hard to retain Emmanuel with us. May we work hard never to lose your presence in our lives. God, even when we are under pressure by our peer groups, our colleagues, our family members, Lord, keep this consciousness in us that we need your presence. Without you, we can do nothing. I bless this, your children, as they prepare to go and celebrate 2018 Christmas. Because you have come here to sing unto his glory in Christmas carol, and because you have participated in this program tonight, the joy of Christmas will never cease in your life. The miracle of Christmas will never cease in your family. All the things that accompany the presence of God, Emmanuel, security, favor, open door, healing, divine blessing and prosperity, this Christmas shall bring it into your life and family in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. The Lord shall secure you. Amen. The Lord shall fight for you. Amen. The Lord shall hear your cry. Amen. The Lord will settle your family. Amen. The Lord shall give you joy. Amen. Every garment of sorrow and mourning, the Lord will turn it into celebration. Amen. Because you are here, you will not die prematurely. Amen. You will not die without fulfilling your destiny.
Amen.
Because you are here, Christmas will be a time of testimony in your life.
Amen.
So shall it be. Amen. As you celebrate this year's Christmas, Emmanuel shall be at the center of your celebration.
Amen.
This is our prayer with thanksgiving. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
God bless you.
Thank you.
Students, thank you for the teachers, thank you for the priests and their wives, thank you for the cameramen, the media, and everybody that has participated in this wonderful, joyful evening. As they go, Lord, may your presence go with them. May your power sustain them. May your glory continually shine upon them. And may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And may the blessings of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you now and always. Thank you. for coming.
Hallelujah. Praise God. The 10th Episcopacy of Right Reverend Ephraim Okechukwu Ikako and 10th Anniversary of the Anglican Diocese of Amichi comes up on Monday 7th through Sunday 13th January 2019. It's a power-packed week-long event which kicks off with a world press conference to be addressed by the Bishop at the Cathedral Church of St. Andrew's Amici on Monday, 7th January 2019 at 9 a.m. On Friday, 11th January 2019, comes up corporate Eucharistic service in commemoration of the Bishop's consecration at the Cathedral at 10 a.m. On Saturday, 12th January 2019, dedication of the ultra-modern Diocesan Secretariat, Women Bethany House, the Shen Shopping Complex, College of Nursing Sciences Admin Block and Hostels at 10 a.m. On Sunday, 13th January 2019, it will be wrapped up with Thanksgiving service and fundraising in support of the Diocesan Project at the Cathedral at 10 a.m. God's people, be part of this great occasion. Jesus Christ is Lord forever.